How's it going, everybody? I'm back with another video, and today I want to talk about a series on Netflix that is the talk of the town right now, and that is Dahmer, Monster, the Jeffrey Dahmer story. I think that's how it is. It's such a weird title. It's pretty much another biography on Jeffrey Dahmer, the serial killer who murdered 17 men, young men. Back in the between the 80s and the early 90s, and this series goes into some detail on that, some of the stuff he went through as a kid, some of the stuff he went through in high school, and upwards his first kill. And I'm gonna be honest with you, before getting on the camera, I was really not thinking about doing a video on this because. This is one of those topics, it's one of those stories that I don't necessarily like to talk about because this is something that actually happened. As you guys know, I'm a big horror fan. If you're into the channel, well, here you go. I'm a big horror fan. I love scary movies. I love the horror genre. As you can see, peep the hat. I love this stuff, man. I love a good scare. I love suspense. I love thrillers. I love a lot of stories that are slashers. I love a lot of slasher films. And so... in talking about this, I want to be respectful because obviously there's a lot of people that was affected by this and there's a lot of families that went through a lot of hardships because of the events that happened and the things that are told throughout the series. So I just really want to talk about it. Is this really a review? I don't think so. It's more of just a discussion because I want to talk about it because it is interesting, to talk about these sort of things. So that's what I'm going to do. If you're here, thank you for being here. Let me know your thoughts about the series, what you think about the Dahmer case and everything that happened. Of course, let's be respectful. I'm going to be as respectful as I can in this. And I just want to talk about it and see how this goes. I might watch this back and be like, maybe I shouldn't post this. You know what I mean? Because it's just one of those topics that I sometimes don't feel the greatest about talking about. But I think I'm going to try. So if you're here, if you're new here, if you wouldn't mind liking this video, subbing to the channel, if you appreciate anything I say, you think I have a good gesture on the events of this series, and yeah, we'll have more content like this. So with that being said, let's get into Monster, Jeffrey Dahmer story. So, what can I really say about it? So let me say this. First and foremost, I see a lot of you guys and a lot of you females out there that are like acting like this is the most uncomfortable viewing experience you've ever seen and that it's one of the most like haunting pieces of media that's ever been produced. And I'm like, dude, get that shit out of here, dude. Let me just be honest with you. Okay, so I'm not going to talk about the murders themselves because obviously we know how grotesque and disgusting and vile they were. But let's talk about the production value. Let's talk about the show and the series as a whole. Listen, we all have different things. We all have different thresholds. What gets us? What worries us? What scares us? What gives us pure terror? I don't see how you're getting it from this series, okay? One, Evan Peters plays the role so well. Man, he has Dahmer's mannerisms, the way he talks, his dialect, his... his mannerisms, obviously, I was going to branch off of that. His movements, the way he walks, hand gestures. It's scary how closely he resembles the actual man, the actual guy. And it's really cool. And honestly, in that front, it's a treat to watch because they have somebody who has almost like serious passion to show and to portray the story they're trying to show. And to tell. The story is very dark, as we know. Opens up very dark with his last victim. He doesn't kill that person. That's kind of basically how he gets caught. And it kind of from then on the series backtracks. It goes a little bit farther into his past. It goes into him being a child, like 10 years old. It shows like the situation, his home life between his parents and. Shows him going to school and his weird obsession with he gets into taxidermy because of his father, and which, by the way, I know some of this stuff didn't actually happen or happened differently, so excuse me if there's you know the real facts. But going through the series and you're seeing these things and you're seeing him grow this this fascination with cutting people open, with like the kill like got him sexually driven. Like it drove him like in a very erotic manner. And almost like he got off of hurting people and doing and mutilating their corpses and things of that nature. So it's just some really, really dark stuff. And on that front, it is. I will say, you know, I have a pretty high threshold. One thing I'll say is, like, you know, I was talking to my sister about it yesterday. And I think my threshold is so high that even, like, let's go back to Walking Dead season 7 premiere, where Negan kills Glenn and Abraham. Those are very, very gruesome deaths. And those deaths, when watching them, they did get me. But I will say, I did read the comics before that. I knew this was coming. And seeing how they died on screen in this way, it did hit me a little bit. Not that I was crying. I wasn't crying. I was boohooing. Matter of fact, I love Negan so much that I was almost, in a weird way, kind of excited to see this on the small screen, I guess you could say. But, you know, it just the way it happened, how bloody it was. I remember my cousin, he was staying over with me at the time, and he had some breathing problems, and I had to take him to the hospital the night of the premiere. And I remember just like waiting in the waiting room, and I was like, and obviously it's like the weirdest place because I'm in a hospital, so there's like blood and people dying and shit like that. And I don't mean to make a joke of that. I'm just saying it was kind of very convenient that I was in this area when I was thinking about it. But like, I'm sitting in the waiting room and I'm thinking about how gruesome those deaths were. And that was like the only time I really watched something that really just had me like wild, because I couldn't believe what I was watching. This whole series is nothing like that. Now, what was unsettling was the way he was acting. You know, going up to his last, he was going to make this guy his last victim. Obviously, he survived, but he went up to him and he said, "Let me hear your heartbeat because I'm going to eat it," and stuff like that. I mean, the way he talked, he was definitely very, very creepy and unsettling. Even some of the stuff he was doing, drinking the blood and you know, like cutting out the intestines of these animals, and then doing the same thing with people, cutting them up into pieces, putting them in bags, taking them out to the dumpster, the you know, things like that. But all in all, though, not very scary, very unsettling, because he was a very deranged individual. And I think this series did a good job on that. Now, I will say this. I haven't watched my friend Dahmer. I haven't really seen too many iterations of the Jeffrey Dahmer other movies, like the other, you know, people have played him. Because I've never really been into that. You know, I think the only thing I've really watched recently like that was the Ted Bundy, the one with Zac Efron in it, which I thought was pretty well done. Focused more on his court case and the show that, like, more of the aftermath as opposed to showing you killing the victims. And so I've never really been too big into these kinds of stories, but this one was very interesting. It kept me hooked to the very end. It went over a lot of themes that definitely were that are still accountable to this day. You know, with the police department, things like that. You know, I try not to get super political over here, but I do think that it was just for what the people of that community were fighting for. The law was stupid. To be honest with you, and I think everybody knows this, and this is really the only big thing I'm gonna say about the whole situation altogether, is the fact of really Dahmer would have never killed as many people as he did if the law wasn't so bad. The law, the authority that's supposed to protect the people, they failed. And that's why this happened. And it happened for so long. So as scary as Dahmer is, and he is creepy, he would have never gotten away with it if the cops did their job. I'm going to be honest with you. Dahmer comes off as he's not a very smart, not a very smart killer. You know, and like I said, he killed people, man. I'm not going to talk about it. But he wasn't very smart. He was like killing people in his apartment. You know, people are smelling the rotting flesh smell. And he's over here like, "My fish died." And, "Oh, I love pork chops." Like, the fuck? Like, what kind of pork chop is you eating that smell like that? Like, everybody can pretty much, unless you just like, you know, you're like impaired somehow here. I don't understand how you can't tell the difference between like a rotten smell like pork chops or like chicken and then human flesh. It's not that I know from experience, but I can pretty much tell you, I guarantee you I could tell the difference. You know what I mean? But you know, anyway, look, all in all, man, you know, it's an interesting story. I don't really want to go too far in detail in it because, like I said, I don't, I was almost skeptical to even talk about it in the first place. But look, it's very creepy, very unsettling. Evan Peters does a good job as Dahmer. I think everybody who was cast did a phenomenal job to paint this picture and to show the aftermath of his killings, and just how demented he was as a person. And really, he's not a person; he's a monster. It's even creepier, you know, when he's in prison, he's talking about it. Very, very, seems very sane, you know, when talking about it. But he goes into depth and detail about how he mutilated the bodies, where he did it, how he did it. Yeah, I think it does a really, really good job of painting a full picture that I don't think a lot of other docuseries up to this point, I guess you'd call it that. I know this is more for dramatic purposes, this series is, but I think it does it better than most of the other series that have tried to do this or try to replicate it. This has done a really good job of really painting that full-on picture of who Dahmer was and how it affected the people around him. So that's really all I got for this video. I know it probably sounded more like me rambling, you know, and you know, I don't really want to go into full more detail because I just don't feel like it's necessary. It was very unsettling. Dahmer's creepy. And I like the themes that centered around his character and how he affected other people and, how it told us how it affected other people. I don't like that it happened, but you know how they told that. Yeah, it was all interesting. And by the way, spoiler, I like how they put all the John Wayne Gacy stuff at the end. They really, because it showed you that that stuff kind of happened around the same time and they're being compared to one another. And both of them were like, no, I'm nothing like that guy. No, I'm nothing like that guy. And it's just, you know, it was really cool to see that. Even if it was like a small part of the series, I thought that was really cool to see that, to see both of those sides of it. So, but yeah, that's all I got for you for this one. If you wouldn't mind liking, subbing to the channel for more content like this. Me and Jan just did our most recent Deadhead podcast. I went ahead and actually I just ended the podcast and I said, screw it. I've been feeling well. I've been feeling really tired. I'll go ahead and film another video now. So here it is. And hopefully it'll be out the next day. So watch the podcast. Watch this. And well, if you made it this far, you watch the video, let us know what you think. And there'll be more in the future. And we'll see you soon. Stay dead, my friends.